Hi guys, let's have a look at the following application. Here we have a header with a breadcrumb that shows us that the user is currently under the ECS schema version 1, then they are under the field sets navigation tab. This is reflected in the URL in the browser, as you can see here. When the user clicks on the other navigation tab, the URL is updated and the appropriate content is displayed. Instead of the ECS field sets table, we see now the ECS fields table. Yet, as you may have noticed, the breadcrumb is still holding the name of the previously selected tab field sets instead of showing the current one. But when I refresh the browser tab, it will be updated. This behavior looks like a bug that we need to fix. But let's investigate the source code first. So here we have the template of the view we have seen on the browser. It contains two nested components. The first one takes care of the rendering the breadcrumb. The second one renders the navigation tabs and their appropriate content. Let's check now the breadcrumb items, which are given as an input to the libbreadcrumb component. So the breadcrumb items variable is actually an array that is initialized in the ng on init lifecycle hook with the return value of the getBreadcrumbItems method. The method returns an array with three JSON objects. Each one of them has a label, could have a router link, a translate property to know if the item needs to be translated or not, and some other optional properties. When the user clicks on a different navigation tab, the libnavigationbar component will emit the selected index change event, which will trigger the onSelected index change method. This method will update the value of the currently selected tab name and the third item in the breadcrumb items array. So at first look, the code looks fine. Let's set a debugger here to make sure that the label of the third item in the breadcrumb items array is updated correctly. I need to go to the browser now and switch the navigation tab. And here we go. Before updating the last item of the breadcrumb, it had field sets as a label. After updating it, its label is changed as expected to fields. So the question is, why this change is not reflected in the UI? Before answering this question, let me show you something. I will remove the line where I'm updating the label of the third item in the breadcrumb items, and instead of it, call the getBreadcrumbItems method and save its return value in the breadcrumbItems array. Okay. Let's go to the browser and perform the same scenario we did before. All right, everything is working as we wanted now, which is great. Are you interested in knowing the reason? Well, we are dealing with a data immutability issue here. Immutability is a fundamental concept in programming and computer science. Let's start with the word itself. Immutability comes from the word immutable, which means unchangeable. Now, when we say a variable or object is immutable, it means once the variable or object is created and assigned a value, that value can't be changed. If you need to modify the value, you actually have to create a new variable or object with the new value. Why is this important? Well, let's consider a situation where a critical piece of data, such as a financial transaction record, is suddenly altered because a bug that inadvertently modifies the data. If that data were immutable, the bug won't alter it. That's why considering immutability in our code design enhances data integrity and reduces the risk of data corruption in our applications. What is data corruption? Data corruption refers to unintended alteration or damage to data, which becomes invalid, unreadable, or incorrect. As a result, You can no longer trust or use reliably the data for its intended purpose. This can occur because of various reasons, including software bugs, such as concurrent access to mutable data. Here you risk that one thread modifies the data while another one is using it. Hardware failures or unauthorized access. With immutable data structures and objects, you can prevent unintended modifications, make the state of data predictable, and safeguard it against corruption. Let's talk about immutability in JavaScript now. In JavaScript and TypeScript, primitive types like numbers, strings, and Boolean are immutable. This means if you create a variable with one of these types and assign it to a value, you can't change the value. If you need to change the value, you actually create a new value and the variable will point to this new value. Here is an example. Here we aren't actually changing the original string hello world. We are creating a new string hello Raqia and making the variable message point to it. However, things get a bit trickier with non-primitive types such as objects and arrays. Because they are mutable and you can change their properties or elements, like in this example. To make the object person immutable, we can use techniques like ECMAScript 6 spread operator. I can give you a tip here on how to check if two JavaScript variables or objects have the same reference in memory or not. Here I'm defining a first object and assigning a value to it. Then defining a second object and assigning the first object as value to it. When I check whether the two objects are equal with the three equals operator, you can see that I get true. So they have the same reference in memory. But when I assign an independent value to the second object that looks the same as the first one, then I check the equality, I get false. Because they don't have the same reference in memory this time. Let's go back to our first example and explain the difference between the two approaches used before and after fixing the breadcrumb bug. With the following line, I'm modifying the label property of the third item in the breadcrumb items array. This operation mutates the existing object's property by updating the label of one of its elements. But the breadcrumb items array itself remains the same. In other words, the reference to the array in memory remains unchanged. This means that the variable breadcrumb items still point to the same array in memory, and the view in the browser that is bound to this array will not be aware of the change to one of its properties or elements. In the second approach, I'm assigning a new value to the entire breadcrumb items array. I'm replacing the existing breadcrumb items object with a new object returned from the getBreadcrumbItems method. In other words, I'm reassigning the variable breadcrumb items to a completely new object and discarding the previous object. Many frameworks like React or Angular use a concept called immutable data for efficient view updates. When you mutate an object's property, the framework might not detect the change automatically because it doesn't see the reference to the object changing. To ensure that changes to your data are detected by the view, you often use specific mechanisms or frameworks that provide ways to handle immutability and update detections. The goal is to ensure that the objects you work with, including their properties, cannot be modified after creation. You can use libraries like ImmutableJS or techniques like Object Freeze in JavaScript to create truly immutable data structures. Immutability in Java. Java developers are generally more aware of the benefits and best practices surrounding the immutability issue. This includes thread safety. Immutable objects can be safely shared among multiple threads without the need for synchronization. This reduces the risk for concurrent access issues. Caching. Immutable objects can be cached more efficiently since their values won't change. This can improve the performance. Security. Immutable objects can't be modified after creation. This reduces the risk of security vulnerabilities. In Java, immutability is often more explicitly encouraged and enforced through the availability of many immutable classes in the standard library. But you can also make objects immutable by leveraging language features such as make fields private and final. This prevents direct access to modification of the fields from outside the class. No setter methods. Avoid providing setter methods that allow the modification of an object state. Constructor initialization. Initialize all fields in the constructor and make sure that the constructor assigns value to the final fields. This sets the initial state of the object, which cannot be changed afterward. Override equals and hashcode methods. If your class is meant to be used in collections like hashMap or hashSet, override the equals and hashcode methods to ensure proper behavior. Avoid mutable types. If your class contains reference types like collections, make sure they are either made mutable themselves or are defensively copied during initialization to prevent external modification. Return copies. If your class needs to return references to its internal state, for example, arrays or collections, return copies to these objects rather than the originals to prevent clients from modifying the initial state. Ensure deep immutability. If your class contains fields that are objects themselves, make sure those fields are also made immutable, or perform deep cloning to ensure mutability at all levels. Here is an example of an immutable class. Here, the immutable person class follows the techniques mentioned before. It has private final fields, no setter methods, and the constructor initializes the object state. This ensures that once an immutable person object is created, it cannot be modified. Immutability in Python and Django. In Python, mutable data structures like lists or dictionaries are the adaptable chameleons, ready to evolve with your command. But be cautious, as their dynamic nature can sometimes lead to unexpected twists in your Python adventures. Immutable data structures like tuple and strings always maintain their integrity and make your life easier. Let's see now two practical scenarios where this technique can improve performance, data consistency, and code reliability. Caching and optimization. Immutability can improve performance and reduce memory usage by allowing objects to be cached safely. For example, if you want to cache the result of a computationally expensive function, immutability ensures the cached value remains consistent and can be safely shared among multiple requests. Such a scenario improves response times. Multithreading and concurrency. While Python Global's interpreter lock, or GIL, limits true parallelism, concurrent code is still common. Immutability ensures data consistency when working with multiple threads. For example, in a Django web application, multiple threads might access or modify user session data. By using immutable objects, you can reduce the risk of data corruptions and simplify synchronization. In this example, immutability is used to create a new modified session object. This ensures that the original session object remains unchanged and available for other threads. The immutability of data has several advantages, including prevent bugs, improved predictability, easier debugging, and better performance in specific scenarios. The absence of a good grasp of the immutability concept will lead to bugs, unexpected behaviors in state management, for example, and misuse of the on-push change detection strategy in front-end frameworks like Angular. It's like wandering in the trail and getting lost in the woods. So that's it for today, guys. If you liked the video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you next time.